Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss nanotechnology in a very ground level understanding. We will discuss nanomaterials, its application, features, advantages, disadvantages, and reasons behind this effect with some future possibilities and all of these in this whole context of nanotechnology. First thing first, let's go to the introduction of nanomaterials. Basically, any particle, crystalline, amorphous, of any organic or inorganic material whose size are in the range of 1 to 100 nanometer can be termed as nanomaterials. And nanotechnology are the study and application of these particles. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 9 meter. And for reference, if we compare a single sheet of paper, it is around 75,000 nanometer thick. The concept of nanotechnology was first introduced by American physicist Dr. Richard Phillips Feynman. He once said that there is plenty of room at the bottom. Invention of a scanning tunneling microscope is done in 1981 and then the C60 molecule in 1985. This is the picture of C60 molecule, and to study these nanoparticles we use mostly electron microscope, scanning tunneling microscope and atomic force microscope. First question that came in every mind while studying nanomaterials is that what happens as particle size become very small? I will tell you what happens. The property of things changes when they are made smaller, and this phenomena is based on quantum effects. And these quantum effects dictate the behavioral properties of particles. So that means scientists and engineers have the power to adjust and change the material properties by changing its size according to their requirements. Basically, first major things happens is that when particles become smaller and smaller, as you can see in this image, the surface area increases but the volume remains constant, and that increases the surface to volume ratio of the atoms, and that's why specific properties dominates. Second major thing that happens when particle size are very small is that energy band gap increases between the covalent band and valence band. For this to happen, particle size is to be less than 10 nanometer, and as the band gap increases, non-metallic behavior starts dominating. Third major thing that happens is that particles at this small size behaves as super paramagnetic, as they have more distorted electric and magnetic dipoles than in bulk material. The increase in the band gap is due to the quantum confinement. The reduction in the number of atoms in a material result in the confinement of normally delocalized energy states. And that's why the electron hole pair becomes tightly confined when the diameter of a particle approaches the de Broglie wavelength and electrons in the conduction band. As a result, the energy difference between energy bands is increased with decreasing particle size. Some known origins that cause physical properties to change are large fraction of surface atoms, large surface energy, spatial confinement, reduced imperfections. As you can see in this figure, gold atoms are becoming gray and then red as the size approaches to smaller nano dimensions. Most of the blue and green color in butterfly wings are identified to be due to microstructures ranging from 300 nanometer to 700 nanometer in the wing scale. And these are structural colors having visible range of about 300 to 700 nanometers, and it is physical color resulting solely from interactions of light with structures on the butterfly wings. And then interaction of light with nano rough surface can lead to constructive or destructive interference. Color intensity or angles of iridescence depends on thickness angle and frequency of incident light. With this property, several applications of nanomaterials mimicking butterfly structure are possible. Let's see the features of nanomaterials. As you can see in this image, more surface area give rise to more reactive sites, and that increases the chemical reactivity, and that's why nanomaterials have high reactivity. Let's see some more features of nanomaterials. Nanomaterials have reduced melting points because of a huge fraction of surface atom in the total amounts of atom. Nanomaterials are ultra hard, and the enhancement in mechanical strength is simply due to the reduced probability of defects. Ferromagnetism disappears, and transfer of supermagnetism in the nanometer scale is due to the huge surface energy. Self-purification is an intrinsic thermodynamic property of nanostructures and nanomaterials, due to enhanced diffusion of impurities, defect, dislocation to the nearby surfaces. Increased perfection, enhanced chemical stability. Now look at the applications of nanomaterial. As you can see in this figure, flexible, bendable, foldable and stretchable electronics have been developed using semiconductor nanomembranes. Their monocrystalline structures with thickness of less than a few hundred nanometers, and these membranes also make materials water resistant, scratch resistant or anti-reflective. Nanomaterials shrink the size of computer chips and helps to enlarge memory capacity. Nanotech leads to a faster, smaller, smarter and more portable system and products. Nanomedicine is the application of nanotechnology in medicine. It is used for disease prevention, diagnosis and treatment. Nanoparticles can encapsulate or otherwise help to deliver medicines directly to cancer cells and minimize the risk of damage to healthy tissue. Due to the large surface area of nanoparticles, it provides a reaction platform for different molecules, as you can see in this image, and thus provide ease in treatment. Basically, Cesel classified the nanostructured materials as zero-dimensional, that is quantum dot, one-dimensional, that is quantum wire, two-dimensional, that is quantum well, three-dimensional, that is bulk system, and you can see this in image shown here. Let us take an example. Look at the uses of titanium dioxide nanomaterial in daily life components. It is used as a UV filter in sunscreen products to protect the skin from harmful UV rays when exposed to sunlight. It is also used as food and drug colorant, plastic colorant, inks and paints. There are various future use for titanium oxide nanomaterial. Its coating can be used to make self-cleaning surfaces. It can also be used as replacement for silicon mid solar cell, as it is a very good absorber of solar radiation to the UV light range. It has various other possible uses in battery, in medicines, in the upcoming future, you can say. There is also some pitfalls of nanotechnology. There is a genuine concern that nanotechnology will further increase energy and environmental cost, given that the production of nanomaterials themselves takes a large amount of energy, water and environmental polluting chemicals such as solvents, etc. Nanoparticles can get into the body through the skin, lungs and digestive system, thus creating free radicals that can cause cell damage. Once nanoparticles are in the bloodstream, they will be able to cross the blood-brain barrier. Nanobots, because of their replicating behavior, can be a big threat. So close, yet so far. There are lots of possibilities in the upcoming future. Nanotechnology is an act of exploration and we are very much still in the early stages. Do you remember the nanomaterial suit of Iron Man? It can be a reality in near future, but to make a suit like that, a huge amount of money is required for sure. If we generalize the study of nanomaterial according to size, if it is a electronic property, then maybe you have to be in the region of 1 to 10 nanometer. And if you are looking for the mechanical properties, 40 nanometer to 100 nanometer are enough. So overall you will have different effect based on what kind of properties you are looking for. Another major future possibility is the nanobots. These are small nanorobots and these are said to be the upcoming marvel of nanotechnology. And it has the potential to address many health problems beside cancer, such as unblocking blood vessels in hard to reach areas, taking biopsies or measuring levels of certain chemicals. It can repair the DNA. It can destroy the harmful viruses. Thank you for watching. I have tried to explain all the terminologies regarding nanotechnology in a very short time period and in a very basic level. So thank you for watching and I hope you like it.